Welcome back. I'm joined now by Ms. Phyllis Banks with APD. Thanks for being here.
Good evening. Thank you for having us.
Now, for those of you who don't know, she's no stranger to this desk, as she used to be the weekend anchor here at Fox. So it's good to have you back.
It's good to be back. It really is.
Well, one thing we want to talk about is holiday shopping safety. I like the holiday shopping part, but sometimes we get so excited around this time of year that we forget the safety part of it. One thing you guys might think is kind of funny that we report on every year, and it happens a lot, people don't lock their car doors, and then they get gifts that they just bought stolen out of their cars. What can we do? It is
the simplest form of crime prevention is to make sure you lock your door when you're leaving it at all times. Whether you're running into the store quickly for just a few seconds, lock your door. And when you're locking your door, make sure you have all your valuables secure. Take your purse, ladies. We still have incidents where ladies leave their purses in the car, and we're not talking those little cheap purses either. We've seen purses of up to $500 taken out of cars. So ladies, please do not leave your purses in the car. And weapons, we do get a lot of reports where weapons are left in the car. So those are some things that we would, you know, appreciate people not leaving in the cars. If you just, you know, hit that little button real quick or mash that little button and secure your vehicle and take all the valuables out, probably be a lot easier for you.
Now, she's smiling because a lot of you might be laughing with us thinking, who doesn't lock the car? But y'all have quite a few cases.
We do.
Every holiday season, and it's not just Christmas, it's Black Friday,
yes.
Cyber Monday.
Yes.
So this whole time that people are shopping for toys, for adult gifts, children's gifts, this is something that you guys encounter on a regular basis.
And it's so interesting when we have one in a particular area occur, it's not just that one, it's several. Because what they do is they'll case the area. Mm-hmm. If they feel like they can get one, let's try some more. And usually that's the case. We'll have a number of cases in one particular area. So we try to send out alerts and prepare people for that, especially when we see a spike in certain areas.
Absolutely. Well, we have a video to show right now. Colby Gallagher last week did a story on this exact thing. Now, what's easy is she's showing how to just lock your vehicle. Mm-hmm. Literally takes 2 seconds. But Lee County, their sheriff's department was dealing with this guy right here. You mm-hmm. see him rummaging through a car. He did not break into that car. It was simply unlocked. And he did exactly what you said. He went to this car right here. He checked. Oh, the handle's locked. Went to this one. Hey, the handle is unlocked. Mm-hmm. He went in. He stole some items from the vehicle. I'm sure when the owner got back, they were quite surprised. And the only thing they had to do was lock their car door. So I know at home you guys are saying, oh, that's so silly, but we can get excited about meeting up with girlfriends mm-hmm. or friends to mm-hmm. go shopping. And it's something that's so simple that we can forget just like that.
And while we're talking about that, the majority of our cases, the incidents that we receive, 50% of those cases are those with doors unlocked. So it is a huge problem. And what we believe is that we have to change the mindset of people. People are still believing that this is okay, even if it's in their driveway or if it's in their garage. That's not the case now. You need to lock your door every time, all the time, no
matter
where.
Every time, all the time. So mm-hmm. even if you're unloading gifts, a mm-hmm. quick run back and forth to the house, mm-hmm. doesn't matter.
Or keep a good watch on your car, because that's the other thing. If you see someone suspicious in your neighborhood or around your car, you want to be able to give us a good description of that individual and call police immediately.
All right. We have more holiday shopping tips coming up right after the break. All right. Welcome back. We are talking to Phyllis Banks with APD, talking about holiday safety tips for when you're out shopping, which a lot of you, some may be done, some may not be done. If you're like me, you wait till Christmas Eve so you can run up and down the aisles like a fool. It's fun. But for those of you who do have to shop, parking lot safety is another main issue. We have some tips we're going to throw up on a graphic for you. 4 quick and easy points. However, they're not as simple as they seem. Number one, lock your vehicle doors. We just went over that. Mm-hmm. 2, roll up your windows. Yes. Why is that one there?
That's very important because you don't want individuals to reach inside your vehicle. That's an easy way to, one, unlock the car and then easier access into the vehicle. So you want to make sure your windows are rolled up, totally secure the vehicle.
Carry what you can handle is point number 3. And there's a few things under that because, one, someone could just, if you can't handle the load mm-hmm. you're carrying, they could mm-hmm. take your items.
That's true.
Or they could take your keys mm-hmm. or they could take your purse. So why is it important to make sure you can only carry what you can realistically handle?
One, that gives you the opportunity, if you just have a limited amount of items in your hand, that gives you an opportunity to maneuver a little bit better to and from your vehicle. Your mind, to me, will be concentrating on how are you keeping all of these things in hand. Mm-hmm. instead of watching your surroundings even more. So your attention, to me, will not be as focused if you have a lot of items in your hand. And, you know, I'm a favorite of high heels, but when I go shopping, I switch out of those shoes because I want to be able to take off if I have to.
Absolutely.
And get away very quickly. So it's just some things that you just probably just need to keep in mind. And people probably don't really think that having so many packages, I mean, you're really unfocused. Mm-hmm. Because you're trying not to drop something. You may have something that is, you know, breakable, or
you want to get that whole list done at once.
Yep, get it all done at once. And, you know, everybody has to really be honest. You know, if I go to Walmart or somewhere shopping and I just want to make that one trip into the house, I'm going to try to carry everything I can. But, you know, it can throw you off.
Absolutely.
A little bit.
Mm-hmm. And the last thing we had on there was not to overload your car. Now, mm-hmm. that may sound like it's simple, but the reason is because, hey, if I see an iPad there,
yes,
an iPod there, and I'm
true.
Just glancing,
that's true.
You're
that's
opening yourself up.
That's true. So we encourage people, like you said, especially within the car, do not overload the car. If you can get items in the trunk, that'll be a great thing, a great way to secure your new gifts and any items of valuable. You know, just slip them into the trunk right quick.
Do you guys recommend covering gifts? Like, let's say I went to Toys R Us and I got a few toys and I have a jacket in the car. Should I cover the toys with the jacket, or is that a little too obvious? Or should I run home and drop the toys off and then come out to go back to Target or Walmart? What should I do?
I would just encourage people not to leave anything of value in the car. Let's say they're interested in a jacket. Mm-hmm. What if they're interested in a jacket just, you know, for warmth or whatever? And they're scoping for a jacket, and you have a nice jacket covering up some other items, and see a jacket.
Then they get a jacket and an iPad.
And an iPad, true.
Are there any other safety tips that you can think of, even if they may seem like common sense? Because if it was common, we would all do it.
That's
clearly
true.
We're not all doing it. We're not locking our doors. We're not rolling up our windows, and things are getting stolen. Like you said, 50% of their cases are because of unlocked vehicles.
That's
so
true.
Is there anything else that you can tell our viewers to protect themselves when they're out holiday shopping?
Holiday shopping, make sure you park in a well-lit area. And when we were talking about the parking safety, that's another tip. Try to get in a very well-lit area. Make sure you have your keys in hand. Make sure you have your purse close to you. Try to go out shopping in a group. And if you can, try to shop during daylight hours. Mm-hmm. Try to avoid those late-night shopping. And most importantly, we want everybody to stay patient and calm. I know you say you want to wait till the last minute to rush around and get those gifts,
mm-hmm.
but that can build up some aggravation and your patience gets short. Short patience can lead to something else. So we want to encourage people to take their time, take a breath, and, you know, get your shopping done, enjoy it, but think safety and just watch your surroundings.
All right. Well, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you, girl.
We certainly appreciate it. You have the tips. So if I have to report on this, you know you have been warned. Now, here we go. Here's what's coming up later in the show.